Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see quickly all the advanced tools and effects inside Lightworks 12. Check out the quick index in video description to get help where you need. Let's suppose to have a project timeline ready. You can add effects through the effects button in the bottom right corner. Effects are used for different purposes. Make adjustments on clips, add special effects, or add objects like pieces of text. When you click on Effects, the Add Effects panel appears. This lists, inside category, the full list of effects you can add to your clips. Under Video, you have all effects that can be applied to photos and videos. Under Audio, all effects for sound clips. When you choose a category, a list appears on the panel. Each category shares the same kind of effects. Beside each effect, you have a thumbnail that shows how such effect affects the clip once added. Below the title, you have a short description of what the effect is. When you want to apply an effect on a visible clip, simply place the red playhead on it and then double-click on the effect you want to add to it from the Add Effects panel. On such clip, a colored square is added, indicating that there is an effect on it. In case you have more clips overlapping, the effect is applied on the clip that is shown on the preview. You can check which is the clip interested by checking the thumbnails inside the Add Effects panel. As you can see, each category has its own color. This is very important, since the squares added on the affected clip have the same color of the category the effect belongs to. Once an effect is added, the effects window appears. This is used to edit the effect settings. You can open this window again, right-clicking on the clip and going to Effects and Settings. Here, each effect is indicated with its orange title and, right below, all settings of such effect. Check out the preview to see how the effect changes. On the right of the title, you have two very important buttons. The first one enables or disables such effect, whereas use the red cross to remove such effect. Use Ctrl and Z to undo if you mistake. To delete effects, simply right-click on the clip and go to Effects and Remove. On sound clips, you can apply audio effects. Just put the red playhead on them and go to Audio category. In case you add effects with the playhead on a blank track, you will add an effect clip inside an effect track, indicated by a FX name plus a number. The effect clip behaves like a normal clip, and its effect is applied on all clips under such effect clip. All clips outside the total length of the effect clip won't have the effect applied on them. Each effect clip can collect more effects inside. If you place the playhead on it and add a second effect, all will be collected inside one effect clip. If you place the playhead outside the effect clip and add an effect, another effect clip is created inside a second new effect track. The settings of each effect do depend on its kind. We will see the most important effects you need. For example, if you need to add titles on a clip, add one effect inside Titles category. Crawl and roll are animated text. Titles is the classic static piece of text. Under the effect title, type inside. Below, Choose the text style, its opacity and size. Use face to change its color. Use position to change the text placement, or simply drag the text from the preview. Use shadow and outline to add shadow or gloss. Inside effects, you can add fade transitions to make text appear in or disappear out. Just choose the length of each transition. If you add text inside a clip, this disappears when the clip ends. If you want text independent from clips, simply place the playhead on a vacant track and add a titles effect. The effect clip will contain an independent piece of text that is visible as long as the effect clip is on. With effects, you can also edit position and size of clips. If you add a DVE effect on it, you can edit the clip position, the clip scale, and you can also use crop to remove parts of the clip you don't want to show. There are also effects to make picture in picture or PIP. PIP is the technique that places a video or a picture on another visible clip, usually bigger in size. To do this, place the picture or video that stays on a bigger clip on a lower track. To avoid getting black bars when you do this effect, make sure that the smaller clip covers the whole preview in full, eventually using the DVE effect seen before. Then, place the playhead on the upper clip and add the split screen effect inside the DVE's category. On the effect settings window, turn off the left picture or the right picture to see both clips on the preview. You can set position, size, and crop on the picture remained on to set the PIP. When you use lots of effects on a clip, you need to use video routing. Just right-click on the clip interested and go to video routing. Video routing shows how the effects are applied on the clip. The final clip is obtained starting from the original clip on the extreme left and follows the links to other effects applied, each represented with squares with the same color of their respective categories. These links go from the left to the right, defining the order of the effects applied. If the effects order changes, the final effect on the clip may change. Always check the preview. To change these links, simply click on the end node and drag it. If you drag it towards an effect, you will add such new effect on the total chain. If you click on the black area, you will delete the link. You can also add new links clicking on the starting nodes. All effects that are not linked are simply put off and are never rendered. You can also apply effects that change in time. Let's suppose to change the opacity of a clip to make a fade-in transition. This can be useful to make it appear in time. If the visible clip has the DVE effect inside, you can use opacity to change its transparency level. Next to the bar, there is a watch icon. If you click on it, you will enable the keyframes, all set below. Keyframes are points that do save a property value in the instant of time they are placed. In this way, if you go from a keyframe to another with different values saved, you will obtain a transition from the first property to the second one. The bar below keyframes describes how keyframes are set. The total length is the length of the clip interested. The red rhombus is the playhead and what the preview is showing. The keyframes are represented as colored triangles. When you enable the keyframes, default keyframes are added on the extreme edges of the clip, saving the settings you put on the property at the moment you clicked on the watch. Then, to add other keyframes, move the red rhombus and change the property. Another keyframe will be automatically added. To edit the value that the keyframe must save, simply place the rhombus there and edit its property related. If you want to delete the point instead, place the rhombus there and click on the minus on the left. Thanks for watching! Check out our guides to discover more in video editing.